The next category in the rating system is site selection and planning. There are 2 mandatory requirements and 11 credits in this category. For ease of understanding and studying for the IGBC AP examination, we will group the mandatory requirements and credits in site selection and planning into 6 groups. Mandatory requirement 1, 2 and credit 10 are associated with best practices in construction. We are going to discuss them together in a group. Credit 1, 2 and 3. Credit 1, basic amenities. Credit 2, proximity to public transport. Credit 3, low emitting vehicles are associated with site location and transportation. We are going to discuss them together as group. Credit 4, natural topography or vegetation. Credit 5, preservation and transplantation of trees are associated with vegetation in the site. We will discuss them together in a group. Credit 6 and 7 are associated with heat island effect. We will discuss them together in a group. Credit 8 is associated with light pollution. We will discuss it separately in another group. Credit 9 and credit 11 are associated with accessibility in design and green building guidelines. We will discuss them together in another group. In summary, site selection and planning have 2 mandatory requirements and 11 credits. We are going to discuss them in 6 groups. Let's start with the first group of mandatory requirements and credits associated with best practices in construction. Mandatory requirement 1, local building regulations. As the name implies, this mandatory requirement is associated with compliance of local building regulations. The intent or objective of the mandatory requirement is to ensure that the building complies with necessary regulatory codes and standards. The compliance requirement for the mandatory requirement can be broadly classified into compliance prior to construction and compliance prior to occupancy. Prior to construction, the project should have approved site plan and building plan. The approval shall be from state government or central government authority as applicable to the project location and size of the project. For larger projects with area greater than or equal to 20,000 square meter built up area, the project should have approved environmental impact assessment report or environmental clearance certificate as per the guidelines of Ministry of Environment and Forest or relevant state environmental authority. Prior to occupancy, the project should get completion certificate signed by the architect, owner or third party commissioning authority, or the project should get fit to occupy certificate from relevant local authority. To summarize, the requirements can be classified into requirements prior to construction and requirements prior to occupancy. Prior to construction, the project should have approved site plan and building drawings, and if the project is greater than or equal to 20,000 square meter, it should have environmental impact assessment report or clearance from environmental agency. Before occupancy, the project should have completion certificate signed by the owner, architect or commissioning authority, or a fit to occupy certificate from the local government agency. The next mandatory requirement is soil erosion control. The intent or objective of the mandatory requirement is to control erosion and sedimentation and thereby reduce negative impact to the site and surroundings. First, let us understand the terms erosion and sedimentation. Erosion is a loss of topsoil. Topsoil is rich in nutrients and support vegetation. Loss of topsoil will result in requirements of fertilizer for the landscape and will further damage the soil and water sources of the site. One of the main reasons for erosion is stormwater runoff. Erosion due to stormwater runoff results in sedimentation. Sedimentation is addition of sediments to water bodies.
it is the water pollution. The picture clearly shows how a water body is polluted with incoming stormwater runoff. Further, sediments from construction site are rich in contaminants and create a larger extent of water pollution. The first step in complying with the mandatory requirement is to assess the fertility of the topsoil. Topsoil is a layer of soil within 10 to 20 centimeters from the ground level. If the topsoil is not fertile, submit a report justifying that there is no need to preserve the topsoil. If the topsoil is fertile, preserve topsoil to reuse it on site or donate it. Topsoil is generally preserved by stockpiling, that is, store the topsoil in a place that is not affected by construction and protect it against wind and storm. The protected topsoil then can be reused on site or it can be donated. During and after construction, project should implement erosion and sedimentation controls as per National Building Code. National Building Code addresses erosion sedimentation control in Part 10, Section 1, Chapter 4 and Chapter 5. Chapter 4 is about protection of landscape during construction and Chapter 5 is about soil and water conservation.